Hey kids, welcome back to another episode of Mackey. Today we are going to do something super, super cool. We're going to learn all about shapes. Yes, that's right, all about shapes. But before we get cracking with this episode, let's do our song. Here we go. All right, here we go. Are you ready?
Put your hands in the air, yeah. Jump up and down and spin yourself around. Dance to the music, yeah. And clap your hands. Put your hands in the air, yeah. Jump up and down and spin yourself around. Dance to the music, yeah. And clap your hands. And stomp your feet. Put your hands in the air, yeah. Jump up and down and spin yourself around. Dance to the music, yeah. And clap your hands.
Clap your hands.
And stomp your feet.
Stomp your feet.
And shake your hip.
Shake your hip.
Put your hands in the air, yeah. Jump up and down and spin yourself around. Dance to the music, yeah.
Clap your hands.
And stomp your feet.
Stomp your feet.
And shake your hip.
Shake your hip.
And shout out loud.
Shout out loud. There we go. Let's go and learn about shapes. Right. So our first shape for the day is a circle. Now a circle is a super special and very, very cool shape. A circle has no sides at all. It's just a round line. Have you heard wheels on the bus before? I bet you have. Let's sing it together.
The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round, all through the town.
Let's do it again.
The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. Wheels on the bus go round and round, all through the town, all through the town, all through the town.
Okay, now why did we only do the wheels on the bus and not any of the other verses? Well, that's simply because the wheels on the bus are round. A circle, the first shape that we've learned today. I've got a few other examples of circles. Would you like to see them?
Yes!
Awesome. Let me show you some. Right, so here's another example of circles. These glasses each have a circle as a lens. Yes, that's right, a circle as a lens. Can you see them? And you know what's even cooler about these glasses? Is they've got little circles around the big circles. So there's some cool circles for you today. Where else can we find circles? Have you ever seen anyone putting on makeup before? Well, when they do, often they'll use a little makeup mirror, and that is also a circle. So there's a circle mirror inside a circle container that is the makeup. How about another cool example? Did you ever think, what about a balloon? Balloons are also circles. There's some other very cool examples in the world, such as a ring. How about a soccer ball? A soccer ball is a circle. And what about the sun? The sun is also a circle. Now, boys and girls, I want you to run around your house now and go and find some circles and ask your parents to type in the comments below what circles you found in your house. Go! Awesome! Okay, time is up. Now we're going to get onto our next shape. Can you guess what our next shape is? Our next shape now is a square. Now, a square is also a very cool shape. And I'm sure that when we do our little treasure hunt around the house, you're going to be able to find some very cool squares. But what is a square? A square has four equal sides and four corners. That is what makes a square. So now let's see some examples of squares. How about post-it notes? You know, those little sticky notes where you can write messages and stick them on your fridge, or stick them on your homework, or stick them in your books, or leave notes around the house for your parents, or draw little pretty pictures and then stick them up on the wall. Those are post-it notes, and they are square. All right, let's move on to another example. How about, let's think about it. What else could be a square? How about Duplo? Duplo is a square. Do you see how this Duplo has four sides? Yes, and four corners. One, two, three, four corners. So this is a square. What are some other examples of squares? Well, you could get a square picture frame. How cool is that? So walking around your house, you might find some square picture frames. Or tiles on the floor or tiles on the wall. Those tiles are usually square. How about a rubber stamp? A rubber stamp can also be square. So there are a few squares that we have found. Now it's your turn to hunt around the house to go and find some squares. Are you ready? Are you set? Go! Is up. All right, boys and girls, I want you to get your parents to write in the comments below what squares you found in your house. Did you find some cool squares in your house? I bet you did. Now we're going to move on to our next shape. Now the next shape is also a very, very cool shape. It's called a rectangle. Now the cool thing is a rectangle is similar to a square, because it also has four sides and four corners, but the difference is it's like a stretched out square. So it is longer than it is high, or if you turn it up, then it's higher than it is wide. A rectangle has four sides and four corners, but it is like a stretched out square. Let me show you. So here's a little practical example. Right. That is a square. Now if we put two squares together like that, that becomes a rectangle, because you can now see it is wider than it is high. Or if we turn it this way, it is higher than it is wide. So it's like a stretched out square. Now let's think of some real life rectangles. Can you think of any? What you are watching this very episode on right now is more than likely a rectangle. So either your TV, your iPhone, or your iPad are all rectangles. How cool is that? So let's think of some other things that are rectangles. Have you ever walked across a zebra crossing? Well, those white stripes that make up the zebra crossing, each of them is a rectangle. That's very cool, isn't it? So there are so many practical examples in your everyday life where you walk around this world and you see rectangles. Can you think of any? How about a piece of paper? Ha ha! There's a rectangle for you. What about a puzzle box? Most puzzle boxes are rectangles. Very cool, isn't it? So why don't you run around your house right now and go and find some rectangles. Here you go, I'm giving you 20 seconds, and go! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time is up. Okay, kids, as you guessed it, I want you to get your parents to write in the comments below what rectangles you found in your house. Go for it. All right, boys and girls, I know you did a fantastic job of finding rectangles. We've got two more shapes to do. The next one is a triangle. Now, triangles are also a very, very cool shape. A triangle has three corners and three sides. It doesn't matter if some of the sides are longer than the others, as long as there are three corners and three sides, then you have found yourself a triangle. So let's think about some triangles that are outside in the real world. How about a pizza slice? A pizza slice is almost like a triangle, isn't it? It's got three corners and three sides. Fantastic. How about a yield sign on the road? Yes, that is an upside down triangle. Brilliant job. Let's think about some other triangles. Where else do we find triangles? The roof of a house. Right there is a triangle. So if you draw a little house now, the top piece that you do as the roof is a triangle. How cool is that? I bet you were drawing triangles and you maybe didn't even know you were drawing triangles. Another place we can find triangles is on a sailboat. The big sails on a sailboat are triangles. How about we travel all the way to Egypt? And what do we find in Egypt? We find the pyramids, and the pyramids are the shape of a triangle. How cool. And then there's another cool food, Doritos. Dorito chips are also triangles. Now, as you guessed it is time for you to find some triangles. I'm gonna give you 20 seconds to find or think of some triangles and write them in the comments below. Here we go. Time is up. All right, boys and girls, did you find some cool triangles? I bet you did. Right, now the last shape we're going to be talking about is a hexagon. We are going to be talking about a regular hexagon though. So what is a regular hexagon? A regular hexagon is a shape that has six sides, but each of the sides is an equal length. So that makes up a hexagon. Now, to find hexagons in real life is a little bit tricky, and you might have to think a little bit to figure them out. But I'll give you a few examples. You know, those clever little bees that make honey? Well, their hives are made of hexagons. Can you believe it? They make perfect little hexagons where they put the honey inside. That is amazing. That is a hexagon in nature. How about a pencil? So if it's not a round pencil, but a pencil with flat sides, and you look at it from the one end, you probably will see a hexagon. Count how many sides it's got. And if it's got six sides, then it's a hexagon. How cool. Another example of a hexagon is a stop sign. These are all over the road, so just watch out, and when you see a stop sign, say to mom or dad, "Hey mom or dad, look, there is a hexagon. The stop sign is a hexagon." All right, boys and girls, I think that concludes today's episode. I hope you've had fun, and I hope you've learned something new today. But before we go, I've got a little trick for you. This is paper towel, isn't it? What shape is this? You guessed it, it's a circle. But now, the cool thing about paper towel is that if you do this this way, pop one off, this is a square. Exactly. Now, if we take this paper towel and fold it in half, like that, what shape have we got there? A rectangle. And if we fold the rectangle, do some little trick with it, like that, and fold it up a little bit, what shape do we have there? A triangle. Exactly. Well done, boys and girls. I hope you had so much fun in this episode, and I can't wait to see you soon. Like and subscribe, hit the bell, and you'll be reminded when a new episode of Mackey comes out. Bye for now.